Well, good morning. Welcome to Parliament House for South Australia's daily COVID update. I'll go straight to the number today. 3,070 new infections were recorded yesterday. So that's actually a drop. We will see these numbers bop around a little bit, but it's actually fantastic to be going down. 3,070 new cases in South Australia yesterday. Also, very pleasingly in South Australia, we've seen that hospitalisation number plateau at 123. So it's levelling out the hospitalisation at 123, so slightly down on the day before. We still unfortunately have 12 people in ICU in South Australia and one person who remains on a ventilator. So no change to ICU and the ventilator, a slight reduction in those hospitalised, and a slight reduction also in the new cases in South Australia. Pleasingly, in the Women's and Children's Hospital, we still have no patients in ICU. In fact, we haven't had any patients in ICU in the Women's and Children's Hospital. We were concerned about this a week or so ago. There was a lot of anxiety regarding that very tragic death and whether or not we were going to see an overrepresentation amongst younger people. That hasn't transpired. We've had no children in the ICU at Women's and Children's Hospital so far. Yesterday, we saw 19,163 tests which were undertaken in South Australia, and a further very significant reduction in the lab time in South Australia. It's now down to around about 11.4 hours, so a further 3-hour reduction through our laboratory. That doesn't mean people are getting theirs, because it takes time to take the swab, collate those and send them to the lab. But what we're seeing is that lab time is extraordinarily quick at the moment. And so congratulations again to SA Pathology and the private labs who are in South Australia, who are doing a fantastic job. We have had a further slight uptick in the number of SA health staff who have COVID. So we now have 308 SA health staff. So this includes the South Australian Ambulance Service who have contracted COVID, and so obviously this is something that we're keeping a very watchful eye on at the moment. I can also report to you that vaccinations yesterday ticked up again. So I've got to say a massive thank you to everybody who has done that. I think yesterday was 19,998 in South Australia, and very pleasingly, about 15,500 of those were boosters. But I still want more, and tomorrow I'll be doing a press conference with Professor Spurrier, and we'll be talking about some additional capacity that we are going to be putting in to, if you like, ramp up the availability of vaccinations and boosters here in South Australia. It is still the very best thing that you can be doing this year, is to go out and to get that booster, get that vaccination. I'm very pleased to see some people having their first shots yesterday, almost 1,000 people. I think about 1,500 people having their second shots in South Australia. This is really good news in South Australia. I'm very pleased that the people are taking this Omicron variant particularly seriously. I've now got to talk just a little bit about the rapid antigen test changes that came out of the National Cabinet yesterday. So what we decided unanimously across all jurisdictions present at the meeting is that we would use a positive on the rapid antigen test as an alternative to getting a PCR positive. So in the coming days, as I said yesterday, we'll be outlining exactly how this is going to occur, and I can tell you more about this today. In fact, I've just come from a meeting, the COVID Ready Committee meeting, where we went through some detailed preparations that are already in place so that this can be rolled out in South Australia. People who are close contacts need to identify or be identified by SA Health. They will then be sent a QR code that they can go and collect an SA Health rapid antigen test. In fact, they will receive two of them, one for day one, one for day six. If they get a positive on the day one, they will be deemed to be COVID positive. No need for a corresponding PCR test. So this will reduce the pressure on our PCR tests in South Australia. It's about 95% accurate, and the whole country yesterday agreed that this was the best use of our finite PCR testing capability across the state. So all the work is being done at the moment within SA Pathology, within IT, within the Department of Premier and Cabinet, and also SA Police. In fact, the State Emergency Centre will be setting up the collection points across South Australia. It's a huge logistical exercise. It is quite a change from where we were some time ago, but this is the appropriate response for this part of the disease. But I emphasise this needs to be an SA Health rapid antigen test. We don't want to deplete those that are available in the general public. So you'll need to identify yourself, get that QR code, go and collect the two rapid antigen tests, administer them, and then of course feed that data into our system. Now we want it fed into our system because we want to have the very best data possible so that we can continue to really closely monitor this disease in South Australia. So that's the general information I'm providing today, and I'm very happy to answer any specific questions.
That system, has that already been set up for GPs and pharmacies to upload that information?
So that will be through our SA Pathology, so it will be a standalone system. So people that consider themselves to be close contacts will need to go on, get that QR code, then go and collect their rapid antigen test. So we're not encouraging people to buy from pharmacies or from supermarkets and administer it themselves if they're a close contact. We want to leave those for people who want to do surveillance. But in terms of those people who are designated close contacts doing their 7 days of isolation, they currently need a test on day one and day six, which is a PCR test. We're just now making it clear that in a few days' time, certainly within the next week, we will move all of those over to rapid antigen tests provided free by the state government.
Will there be follow-up to make sure that people are reporting back? So if they test positive and they don't want to report it back, that is happening?
Well, of course, when they receive that free test, they're then entered into our system, so we will be able to follow that up.
And will you then be reporting them as well? I guess at the moment, do you think today we saw a reduction in cases because fewer people are getting tested?
No, in fact, I think, as I said yesterday, I think demand and supply are pretty much in equilibrium in South Australia. Certainly this morning at the 9 o'clock update, I looked through the entire list of testing sites, most of them were in within 1 or 2 hours, which is fantastic. The outlier was Mount Gambier. We have seen a lot of people that have been holidaying down in the southeast, in particular around Robe, who are going into Mount Gambier. That's why, as of today, we've now set up a new site, a dedicated site at Robe, so that both people are not needing to go into Mount Gambier for that testing.
How confident are you that these tests, the rapid antigen tests, are reliable? We've been contacted by someone who said they took a PCR test, it was positive, and they took a rapid antigen test out of curiosity, and that came back as negative. How confident are you that these are actually giving a reliable?
There's no doubt that the PCR test is more sensitive, especially in the early or the latter stages, but what we know from the clinicians is it's about a 95% confidence. So if you get a positive on the RAT test, you're definitely going to get a positive on the PCR. And of course, if we do the test on day one and then again on day six, we believe at this stage of the overall disease that is sufficient for protecting the population.
You mentioned that it has to be an SA Health rapid antigen test. Is that because they are more reliable than the tests that we can get in pharmacies?
Well, there's two reasons. One, because we have a high confidence level with regards to the quality of the rapid antigen test. We know where we've purchased them from. Secondly, they'll be free to the user. And I suppose the third thing is that then they're entered into our system. So we really want to make sure that we are reporting the full case in South Australia. That's difficult if people are just doing the test, self-diagnosing, isolating, but we're not feeding that into our data. So it's really important we get that data right. And of course, we know that the vast majority of people in South Australia who are COVID positive won't develop debilitating symptoms. But about 0.5% at the moment are ending up in hospital, and about 0.5% are ending up in the medi hotels. The vast majority of other people can be using our COVID hotline for support. And if they're in the system, we're in a much better position to offer all of those separate options to them if their condition deteriorates.
Where do people get this, the SA Health test? Is it from the testing sites, or is it from pharmacies, or is it from both?
So I met with the police commissioner today via Zoom, and he told me that he's in the final stages of identifying where those collection points will be. It is a big logistical sort of exercise because it's not just metropolitan Adelaide. This has got to be the entire state, and getting those rapid antigen test to people quickly. So we'll be in a position in the next day or so to be able to identify exactly where those sites are. Now, some states said that they might do them at the existing PCR testing sites, and some states are completely separate. We're just going through that exercise at the moment. Should have good advice in the coming days.
The policy's in place today, yet you don't know where people can collect them today.
No, it's not in place today, sorry. I'm just giving advice, as I did yesterday, that it'll be in place within the next 7 days.
You mentioned that there are now in excess of 300 SA Health staff who have tested positive to COVID. How concerned are you about the workforce, not just within SA Health, but other essential workers? Because, of course, it's not just people that are testing positive also who are now having to go in isolation. We're seeing short supply of SA Health staff, of transport workers, of supermarket workers, that kind of thing.
Yeah, look, you're 100% right. We are battling two issues at the moment. One is we're not wanting too many people to end up in hospital, so we're wanting to slow the spread. But we've also got to make sure that we maintain a workforce to support those people who are ill at the moment. So it's a very fine balancing act. In total in South Australia across SA Health, we have 573 staff who can't go to work. So 308 are positive and the rest are furloughed. But as I said at the previous press conferences, a lot of those furloughed staff can work remotely from home and support those people who are living with COVID in the community. So they become part of that COVID response care team, what we call the cricket team, and they can do that remotely from home. So they're not completely lost to the overall system, but every single health system in the country at the moment is worried about the loss of employees. This is one of the reasons why we have higher level settings in South Australia in terms of that isolation, and we have a longer time that people are in isolation if they're COVID positive in South Australia. Trying to get the balance right is very difficult, but I think at the moment in South Australia we've got it about right. We have, as I said, at the moment we have 123 people in hospital. This is well within our capacity. We will still see those numbers increase. Certainly the forecast that we're starting to look at again now is showing that we are going to see increasing cases in South Australia. But what we're trying to do is to slow that spread so that it doesn't overwhelm our health system and it doesn't take out our entire health workforce.
I mean, just understand that Salon is sending out text messages to people asking them to come back from leave because they're so understaffed. Is that appropriate?
Yeah, I think we, at the moment, it's all hands on deck. We are trying to get as many people with health qualifications into the system. We're trying to bring people back who might have retired, people still have qualifications to help in vaccination clinics, to help in our testing laboratories. We've seen massive shortages interstate, and we have seen testing times massively blowing out. I know that our times here have increased, but what we've seen in the last 3 days is those numbers come down, which is absolutely fantastic. And there's a very cooperative health workforce in South Australia, both current and past, that are all wanting to get in, do the work, and keep South Australia protected.